Here we go.
Oh my God, this is great. We're live.
Wait, are we gonna get?
It's just us right now, guys.
This is incredible. This is like.
Wait, is everyone gonna be joining this chat? Like, we're in the chat.
I don't understand. The idea.
I don't have a clue, man.
Hold on, I'm opening a Q&A. Hold on.
I'm trying to find that.
Questions. Nobody cares about us. I think I.
So confusing.
I don't know. Should we tell them? If anybody's watching, you can.
This is incredible. Hold on. Can I ask a question?
Why don't we just ask each other?
Yeah, let's just ask each other.
Going down in history is like the greatest one of these.
Wait, there we go. What's your favorite color?
That's your fucking question? Really?
Shut up, somebody asked it.
You have all this brain power here, and you're asking what
your favorite color is? Can we not see? I thought we could see them.
Oh,
wait, did you write that? Okay.
Hold on, we can do this.
How do we type our own questions?
I don't know. Yep. That was incredible. You did it. How'd you do it?
Enter chat message or link here.
Okay. You know, this is an 18-plus chat, so we can just – all bets are off. This is incredible. Is anyone else in the world seeing this?
Is there anyone on?
Hold on, I'm gonna go onto my phone and I'll. Oh, that's a naked picture of my kid. Look. That's great. Hold on, I'll look. Oh man, this is crazy. Technology is really great.
Some questions that they
would. Okay, here we go. YouTube. They're all probably just so overwhelmed by our power. Let's see, I'm clicking.
Technology,
yeah, this is us.
Really great.
Okay.
Wait, what is that? What was this? I didn't even see where y'all wrote. What is your favorite color?
Wait, how are you watching this?
Dude, look.
It's the,
oh my God.
The internet just exploded.
Is this Meta or what?
Okay. Matt, does it tell you if people are watching?
I mean, I don't know. I've never done this. Let's talk amongst ourselves about ourselves, because at least they're seeing it.
Ooh, your camera is really nice there, Nathanson. Do you have what kind of HD? Do you have like a high band width or something?
Updated.
Yeah. I want you to know this. I'm a member of Alaskan Men Catalog, and this is what I use to court my ladies.
It looks good. It's very high def. I mean, I can see every pore on your face, and you look
unfortunate. All right, let me start by asking some questions. All right?
Here we go. People are watching.
Someone just said watching Matt Nathanson, Philip Phillips, etc. try to figure out how to do. It's like it must be like watching your grandparents try and work the remote.
I know. It's exactly how it is.
All right. So I'll play Matt Pinfield.
Okay.
Ready? So I'll start with Philip. You were born and raised in Georgia.
Oh yeah, I was.
Nice. Yeah, and I have a question for you. If this will be musical related, if you could pick two desert island discs, if you were going to be stranded on an island and you had like unlimited coconut water and like other things you needed, and you could only have two albums, what albums would those be?
Holy cow, dude! That's way too serious of a question. I thought we were about to be.
This is my first joke.
Holy cow!
You can also come back. I can send this question to other people, and then you can come back.
Okay, I gotta come back to that.
Okay, I'll tell you my two would probably be Octung Baby and Appetite for Destruction.
Oh,
Guns N' Roses. All right, you guys. Anybody else can answer. I'm directing it to all of us.
Desert list albums, right? You're talking on a desert. You get two albums.
Yeah.
Mine would be Beauty and the Beast.
Oh God! Oh God! No, you don't want that. There's no way. There's no way you're gonna live with that.
Yeah, the movie or the musical soundtrack, like the live stage, or the original soundtrack. What are we looking at?
Yeah, which kind? Which Beauty and the Beast? Tell me. This is great.
The animated Disney movie.
Awesome. That made me cry in college.
Still makes me cry.
Good. I haven't watched it.
I have to say, one of my albums is, it would be Stevie Wonder Songs in the Key of Life, for sure.
Good answer.
That's real good.
Second one I still need some time on.
I'm going to throw out, this isn't technically an album, can I count this? Bob Marley, Legend?
That is definitely a compilation of songs. That works.
That would be, I feel like, you'd always be in the mood to listen to that. It would be good on a desert island in general.
Yeah.
So that came to mind. I'm going to put that one on there. And I'm going to say Abbey Road as my other one.
Yeah, I was going to say Rubber Soul.
Okay. You guys both get two, by the way. Don't count yourselves out.
Oh my God.
One act, you get two albums total.
And we have to listen to these two albums like on repeat all the time.
Well, you guys are in trouble because if you don't like Beauty and the Beast, you're fucked. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I think yes, if you like Beauty and the Beast,
you don't hear any Beauty and the Beast songs on the summer tour, I'm gonna be pissed.
Are we stranded together?
Yeah. Is that,
Andy, if you hate each other's shit, you don't have to be. It's like you're good.
I would say. Have you guys heard Rainy Day Music by the Jayhawks?
Yes. Over Tomorrow the Green Grass?
I'm sticking with Beauty and the Beast and Rainy Day Music.
All right. I like this.
I honestly thought there were going to be like people coming in and out asking questions.
There might be. I'm going to click on a bunch of links and see what happens.
That's what I was thinking about.
The best part is that the only people that have done anything are us.
Wait, there are people on our Twitter saying, how do we ask questions?
Watch this. Watch what I'm about to write.
Uh-oh.
Wait, I wonder if they can see that.
I got a tweet saying that they know what we're talking about, my two albums and everything. So
yeah, they can see it. They can hear us. This is the 1%. This is what it's like to be the 1%. They can't get to us. That was a joke. I got a fucking fern here.
We're getting questions via Twitter.
Oh, exciting. Hold on.
Yeah, why don't we do that?
Tweet your question.
Yeah.
Oh my God, there you guys are.
Actually, we're not getting any questions.
Wait a second.
Questionnaire. So if you guys don't know, we're all touring together this summer, and I'm doing some of the shows. A Great Big World doing some of the shows, and Philip Phillips and Matt Nathanson are doing all of the shows because it's their amazing tour this summer. And one question I got was, will you be doing any collaborations during the tour? # summer tour hangout. This woman created her own hashtag for this. This is a good idea.
I hope we do. I want to sing with everybody. I want everybody to come on stage during our set, and we can all, like, I was going to actually reach out to everybody to see if we could do, like, some Prince song or something. You know,
What about maybe a little Beauty and the Beast?
Dude, it's not fair. It's not fair that you're getting chastised for your choice.
I love Beauty and the Beast. Let me just say this. I was just in France and I was singing Bonjour, 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 Bonjour the whole time in my head. But not
someone said they're asking questions on the YouTube.
Yeah, hey guys, like click on, can you go to the left side of y'all screen and like just do like the apps pop up? Like, does anything pop up?
Well, they said in the comment section of the YouTube channel itself.
Gotcha.
All right, we got another question.
Oh, this is good. You guys are good.
What's your favorite ice cream?
Cookie dough.
Chocolate. I'm simple.
I like vanilla simple.
Ooh, I love vanilla, too.
That's a boring.
Green tea.
There's a new place in New York City. I don't even know if it's new. It's a place that was in LA first called Juice Pressery, right?
Yeah.
And they started they started turning their green juices into ice cream. And so I'm gonna go with them and with that ice cream. Gross.
Yeah. Sounds good.
Well, it's not good. It's really not good.
Do you own it?
If you like ice cream, like you're not gonna like this. It's not ice cream.
Did you start an ice cream place and now you're trying to this is how this works? Hold on. Alright, are there any other good questions like that one?
Jesus. Where are you excited to go this summer on tour?
Wherever anyone likes us.
Where are we going?
Yeah. I'm excited to go to Montana.
Yeah, Montana.
I never played Montana.
Oh, dude, it's awesome. Pretty good.
Great Big World, you're going to be there with us in spirit.
Yeah, we're not on that show, right?
Are we not playing any of the shows with Eric? Is it either Eric or us?
Confusion about that, yeah. Any show that you are on, I am not there.
Oh, God. That's bullshit. That's bullshit.
Bull crap.
I hate it. I won't swear. Hold on. That's crap.
No, you can. I think you can swear. This is 18 plus.
That's why it's 18 plus, because you're here.
Totally. Hold on. I'm going to get more questions. What are your desert island discs? Just kidding. shit.
Who can tell the funniest joke? From Ronnie Perez? This is on Twitter. I'm just looking at Twitter. I don't really know how this the question.
Comment section. I think we need a hangout to ask questions. We are watching. What is your favorite tour place to eat or tour junk food? So what's your favorite tour junk food? That terrible New York ice cream that you don't like?
That's a hard question because I don't really eat junk food.
Neither do I.
So what do you eat?
I'm sort of a hippie.
Well, I don't know if it's really junk food, but I can eat chips and dip, like chips and salsa or whatever it is, like all day, every day, nonstop. Chips and guacamole.
What'd you say?
You have Eric? Chips and dips on the rider?
Yes.
If I get depressed, I can eat a whole Entenmann's cake by myself.
No.
You do it now.
On the tour?
I do it on stage. I just do it if the crowd sucks. I just sit there just
just to get a chair. Just
sit down.
It's a very DJ move. It's like Steve.
All right.
It's kind of like, I guess it could be like, because we've been playing all different songs on tour, so what's the hardest song it took y'all to write?
They're all like, I just read an article where Tom Petty said he wrote Free Falling by accident, like trying to make Jeff Lynne laugh.
Yeah, I just read that too, yeah.
I think that's cruel. Like, that's not nice of him to say. Like, that he can just shit out Free Falling.
Right. Did you see the documentary of that? It's incredible.
Incredible.
Did you hear Jeff Lynne's record, Alone in the Universe?
No, is it the new one?
Yeah, he put out last year. It's like brilliant.
Phenomenal.
He is from another planet, incredible. Like, production-wise, writing-wise. Mr. Blue Sky was the last one that I kind of... No, what was that? It was the documentary from that old song. But I'll totally check it out. We should play something off a Jeff Lynne record.
Oh, yes, I'm in. Yeah. I already know it.
Like the new Traveling Wilburys, guys. Traveling Wilburys 2.0.
And if you want, like, to just add, like, a layer of mystery and, like, authenticity, I'll totally die. Oh, my God. This is a question for Philip.
Uh-oh.
Philip, I was in a music video, in quotes. That's not a good start. I was in a music video. A music video quote that you put together with Do Something about music education in schools a couple of years ago featuring Gone, Gone, Gone. And I'm so happy I got picked to be in it. Matt, I've been a... this is just a bunch... There's no questions.
Wait, Matt, you got to read the question.
gotta filter it first before you start reading.
Hold on. Let's try this again.
Okay, so apparently there's like a chat thing you can do. I'm just not don't know how to do it.
There's literally a world going on around us.
Wait, where are you reading from?
The comments on YouTube.
On YouTube?
Yeah.
Are we on YouTube right now?
Yeah. So Abigail Gupta asked, who out of all of you was most skeptical to do the tour? Oh, shit.
You can read these questions to yourself before you read them out loud.
That got pretty serious.
He's like, which one of you, that's incredible. Which one of you is skeptical to do the tour? What fucking world do you live in of cynicism?
I got one.
Shit.
Andrea Creamer. What is your favorite song of an artist on this tour other than yourself?
Oh, Andrea, Jesus Christ. Andrea, you can't ask, like, stumpable questions. This is not, a trivia game.
Yeah. Matt, when I was in college, I used to listen to Little Victories over and over again. FYI.
Oh, my God, dude. Stop, you're going to get me all set. That's because I'm 75 years old. Hold on. There's some more questions. Matt's finger is being put right in our faces. Abigail, I think you have a problem. Why aren't you happy? Abigail, Gupta, I'm here for you.
What's your favorite song to sing on tour?
Here we go.
Anyone.
I love Abigail's commented a lot. I love Abigail.
Wait, what is that thing, Matt? What is that thing?
That's when the questions get plant. When they cut you close to the bone. You just houseplant. So favorite song to play. Is it anybody? I don't know. What? Okay.
What's your favorite song to play of your own?
Our favorite song to play? What's your favorite song to play?
Well, no, it doesn't have to be a joined.
I like playing Raging Fire during my set.
Oh my God, everybody's kind of fucking
slowed it down and kind of made it better.
What are you doing?
Oh, you guys don't fuck around in New York.
All right, favorite game or activity to play on tour? I've always wanted to do softball, but no one else really wants to do softball, but I would love to do that.
Did you play baseball growing up?
I did, like for many years, and then when I picked the guitar up when I was like 14, I stopped.
I'm totally down with softball.
We play wiffle ball.
That would be cool. Wiffle ball too.
I've always wanted to have a home run derby off the stage.
You know, that's actually pretty cool.
You know, it's like who can get the most into like second mezzanine or whatever. I mean, if you can find a soft enough ball, I think we should do that.
Insurance. Yeah, we just got to get bulk up the insurance.
Frisbee.
Frisbee's
what's the douchiest thing on y'all's rider?
Ah, the douchiest thing?
Yeah. That's what probably Elise says.
I think floor lamps are on our rider.
I think that's kind of genius.
I like it. Douchey. I have our drummer Chris is super into like Mad Men era cocktails. So we get shit like bitters.
You have to have John Hamm there all the time.
And I don't drink, and so I'm always like slightly resentful that at the end of the night, like the rider comes in and it's all booze. Mm. So that's we have got booze. Bitters.
I have no idea what's on my
in the old days it was everything was booze, okay. Partying, and most people I know now, their tour riders are all like I got to have a special blender so I can make my, you know, full octane smoothies. And I feel like most musicians I know, it's annoying stuff, but it's like I need cocoa nibs from this specific region.
We have a Nutribullet on our bus if you guys want to come over and make some smoothies.
Ooh, that's a good idea.
Thank you. Thanks. We have a Vitamix.
Oh, so. Okay. Okay.
Up to.
I'll step off. That's great. Thanks.
Do you guys prefer indoor or outdoor venues?
I like outdoor, indoor. I like them all. Anybody who likes me, I'll be there.
I like it cold. So I'm a little bit nervous about the heat. I sweat like crazy, so
I'll answer that. Someone answer that.
Sorry.
Not me.
I like outside because it feels like when you get to play outside and you're playing music for a living, it just seems like you're cheating the gods twice as much. You know, it's like there's a certain level of like, wow, this is really my job. Yeah, I'm outside, it's beautiful, I'm getting to play music.
Yeah.
But I do sweat a ton, so that has to be taken into consideration.
Yeah, outside just has a cool energy, though, man. Everyone can just, like, chill out, you know, if they're walking around or whatever, you know, sit down on the ground or whatever it is. I like outdoors.
Nice. Yeah, outdoors really nice because it does. It feels like when I was a kid and I used to go see bands, like, in Boston, outside of Boston in the summer, you'd sit and, like, even if you went and saw, like, metal bands, which is what I saw, it was just nice to, like, kind of lie out on the grass and... It was fun, but it definitely feels like you're kind of like winning when you're playing an outdoor shed.
I can't find the answer to the question
either.
Uh-huh. What's your one piece from Tom Padula? What's your one piece of dream gear?
Of what?
Guitar, piano, amp, etc.
Oh,
what's your dream gear?
I'll go first. I played a 1934 0018 Martin the other day that was like out of my price range, and I thought about selling my kit.
Dude, I played a 1926. I gotta look.
I saw the picture.
It was like this Russian guitar, Weissenborn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I saw it. You posted it.
Yeah. Dude, that thing, I recorded for one song that's going to be on the new album. It's it sounded freaking incredible, man. Like, I wanted to buy it, but again, it was just like this ridiculous price.
Yeah.
I feel so left out when people talk about guitars because I don't know how to play guitar. I can't talk about guitars. I can talk about pianos like you guys talk about guitars. So,
what piano would you love to have?
I don't. It doesn't work like that.
Don't you want like a Steinway with like white with like the like an image of a stallion breaking free? sort of emblazoned, like blazing stallion, like that. I think you'd look awesome with that. I think like if you played some of the more tender stuff on the record with a fucking piano with a horse on it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That sparkles.
Sparkle horse.
Yeah. Should we tell what if people are here and they have no idea what they're watching? Should we just tell people why they're watching us right now, or does it matter?
You've tuned in to the greatest technological shit show of 2016. Google Hang out.
Oh, man.
Thank you, Matt Pinfield.
So awesome. He texted me. He's like, I'm having trouble getting on. Like, yeah. We all, I mean, yep. What else?
I'm trying to find more questions.
Are you excited to play the Stone Pony? This is a good question. Stone Pony, Asbury Park, New Jersey, home of Springsteen, very famous, as we all know. Are we excited? I've played there before, and I almost got into a fist fight, so I'm excited to try that again.
Tell us about the fist fight.
What?
Tell us about the almost fist fight.
So I had this thing for many years where I would, if somebody gave me shit from the audience, I would, sometimes I'd just stop the show. And I'd say, why don't you stop fucking talking and come up on stage and let's deal with it. and a couple times it came to blows. One of which was when I almost got killed by two Marines in Colorado outside the Pepsi Center with OAR and Rune 5. That was I pretty much since I had a kid I've stopped being a total idiot. Yep, good story.
Oh man, weirdest fan experience.
Don't answer that. Well, too weird. No, don't answer. They're probably watching.
Exactly.
Yeah. How do we?
What's your, what?
Fans, I from. Just in general, if a fan comes up, oh, how do we do this? Here's the deal. What do you
know about fans? Okay.
My least favorite thing that a fan can do, now that there are people watching, just so they know, just a little feedback. If you come up to us at the end, at like a meet and greet, and you start the sentence with, I'm so disappointed, that pretty much triggers like this super deep, like parental fuck me up thing, and it just like, that's going to send us off into a problem. Does anybody else say, get like being told they're disappointed?
If you're gonna bake goods, the first thing out of your mouth should not be, I didn't poison them, I promise.
Totally. Yeah. or like pubic hair. I just don't want to hear anything about it. I just give them to us. You guys have been, hey Philip, you've been very quiet, and so has Eric when it's come to fan crazy. And you are infinitely more renowned, like in terms of like your net of potentially looping in people that tell you either A, they're disappointed in you, or B, they've baked cookies and there's no cyanide in them. You probably have a good story somewhere. But
I always like call people out. I don't know if this happened to y'all, but it's happened to me quite a few times. Like, man. Big fan, huge fan, man. Been watching you forever. Love your music. So when are you coming out with a new album? I said, well, you got both of the albums. I said, no, I didn't know you had a second one. I was like, oh.
Oh yeah. That's right up there with posting on your Facebook page. When are you coming to Wisconsin? And the fucking Wisconsin date on the fucking books right there in front of them.
Or the day after you were in Wisconsin.
That always happens.
Yeah, yeah.
I think people do that to be a dick. Maybe not.
I'm trying to like figure this out, guys.
How do I delete my penis comment?
Never going to.
It's staring right at me.
Do y'all have like a chat thing on y'all's?
Yeah, you gotta click on
Here, I'll get a couple more questions from the internet.
Why wouldn't show up here?
That's what I can't understand.
Ronnie Suarez, I feel really bad my question about the weirdest fan experience. I didn't know it would be so flippin' awkward. Ronnie, don't sweat it. Do you this is another question. It's hard to get. Is this a Google Hangout or a YouTube Hangout?
That's a good question.
I have no idea. I don't know. I feel like the oldest person on Earth right now. Like I'm using three devices to do one thing. Oh my god. All right. Who is your favorite artist band to do covers of on stage? Okay, let's go in order. Eric.
Favorite? I have a follow-up question. I think there's certain bands that nobody should ever cover on stage.
Ooh, I like this. Okay.
Aretha Franklin would be one of them. I've never seen like Aretha Franklin just get done better.
Okay, and then on a positive note, who do you like to cover?
I like to cover Whitney Houston.
Well, how are you supposed to do Whitney Houston better?
You don't. You don't do it better, but sometimes you gotta just dive in.
All right, Great Big World, what is your... Oh, hold on, I have to check in for my Southwest flight tomorrow. Great Big World, hit me.
Sponsored by Southwest?
My Southwest flight. So, yeah, who do you
cover? We don't really cover songs. I mean, but
What?
Yeah, we kind of just don't.
What if you could, though? If, like, if you were asked, if someone said to you, you have to do somebody else's song.
I want to do Jeff Lynne.
Oh, yeah, okay. Which song off of the record?
I want to do Alone in the Universe.
Okay.
I don't.
I'll do Prince. Let's do this.
Okay. Great. We'll do Prince. And then, Philip, if you covering people's songs, and we can also follow up by Eric's question about who the hell people shouldn't cover. But Philip, if you could, who do you enjoy covering on stage? And if you say Aretha Franklin, Eric's going to get off this call.
I love covering Peter Gabriel.
Oh,
he's my favorite artist. Wow. You do Sledgehammer ever?
What's that?
You do Sledgehammer ever?
I've done it a couple times, but it's been a while. But I usually do Digging.
Digging in the Dirt?
Digging in the Dirt, yeah. I call it Digging. I always forget it's Digging in the Dirt. But, yeah. I love that song, but I want to cover some more of his songs because he's so awesome.
He's so great and so underrated.
He's
classic.
A32.
We should do this more often, like every day.
Yeah.
Peter Gabriel, that's awesome. Peter Gabriel is one of my favorites. We should do Dig in the Dirt or something. I'm totally down.
Yeah, dude. I keep getting other stuff coming in saying I need to look on this like how to answer or ask questions on this thing.
All right.
Eric, here's a question. Are you keeping the jacket? That's from Michael.
Yeah, I'm trying this jacket today, and I asked Twitter what they think of it.
Whoa, oh, that's cool.
Actually, it's really cool.
That's very Bob Marley legend.
It is.
It's a little Bob Marley legend, isn't it?
Yeah.
Here you go, guys.
Yes, I asked to keep it, and I think I'm going to keep it. The reviews were pretty favorable.
Nice. Everybody show what you got on. My shirt has two holes where your nipples would be if your nipples were super close to the fucking middle of your chest.
I just have a blue shirt on.
Okay.
What do you I'm wearing a shirt with a star.
Oh, that's nice.
Spray-painted star. I have, like, red flannel.
Where is everybody today? Eric, where are you?
I'm at home in New York, and I'm leaving tomorrow for about 5 weeks.
What part of New York are you in, Eric?
I live in Manhattan, New
What's
York.
What's your address?
And Philip, where are you right now?
I'm at home in Georgia.
Great. South. What part of Georgia? Is near.
Yeah. Albany, Georgia.
Ah, nice. Yeah. And then Chad, Ian, where are you guys right now?
We're in Manhattan as well. Yeah.
What part of Manhattan? Like, you can't say.
Don't say it. You're moving today. It doesn't matter. I'm moving. Up from the Upper West Side to somewhere else.
I used to stay on the Upper West Side, 75th in Amsterdam, for like 15 years.
Oh, yeah.
Right down the street from where Deborah Lopez used to live.
Yeah, we're over there a lot.
Hey, guys, here's a question from Mariah. What song do you not like? Oh, no, wait, that wasn't it. Crap, it went away. Here it is. Do you have any... It, like, goes down. Do you have any pre-show rituals? And if you do, what are they?
I usually like to rub one out.
Oh, my God.
Is that gross? Oh, I didn't say it. Did I say that out loud?
Said it out loud.
It's not from Mariah. It's from Jenna.
I meant rub, like, the stuff out of my pants.
I don't know. I just usually drink a lot of hot water. I don't have any tea. I just do straight hot water.
I pace around a lot. I get really nervous.
Yeah, I do some vocal warm-ups, and I eat an energy bar. It's exciting stuff.
I'll be honest, but I don't really do what I said.
What do you really do?
I like to just kind of hang out with my thoughts, center myself. Ooh. And oftentimes I like to strip naked, cover myself kind of in like this baby oil. It's like strange. Because at the beginning of a tour I shave my body, and I do it, and then at the end of the tour I see how much hair has grown back in the amount of time.
Right.
So the beginning of tour is really easy.
On a tour like this, how much hair is going to grow back?
I mean, we're talking Wookiee. You know what I'm saying? It's just going to be crazy. just like eruption, right? Just see this thing. And then my unibrow connects with my hairline. It's by the end, I'm going to just look full Teen Wolf.
Sweet.
Next question. The silence is the worst part of the Google Hangout.
That's a lot of fun questions. Oh, man.
Favorite shows to binge watch?
There we go.
Oh, The Leftovers. We just did that.
Ah.
Incredible.
Wait, they're only on the second season, right?
Yeah, so we watched two seasons in, like, very quick.
So good.
Incredible.
I'm on Bloodline season 2 right now.
How is that?
It's pretty awesome. The episodes are long, and it kind of gets drawn out a little too much for me, but at the end of every episode, you're like, holy crap. Right, you've got to watch the next one.
I'm on season 8 of Pawn Stars.
Real?
For real.
Is that the one that Phil Collins from Def Leppard was just on?
Maybe. It's the one in Vegas with the Harrisons, like Rick Harrison and like the old man and okay. Chumbly and Corey.
Where do you watch these?
On my TV.
But like, what are you, like, how are you streaming them? Is Netflix have them?
Hulu has them. And then you can get, I think it's the History Channel app, and they have them.
History Channel?
Five seasons on iTunes, which I haven't done yet.
What's your favorite season so far?
I don't have a favorite season. I just like the ones where, like, someone finds out they have something that's worth, like $1 million, and they got it at a garage sale. That always gets me going.
Yeah, that's the dream.
Antique Roadshow, it's the same way. Every time somebody brings in, like, a painting.
It really gets me going. It really gets me going.
Antique Roadshow messed up recently. They it was like a high school paper mache, like, sculpture, and they said it was from, like B.C.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, that's heartbreaking.
And someone came out and was like, I made that in high school.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh. What's wrong with humanity?
Sorry, I'm trying to look for questions, y'all. Sorry.
I got him. What will you miss most about being on the road for tour? Being on tour, what will you miss most about home?
Got it.
That was incredible. Everybody was like,
I'm going to miss just being at home. I like to cook. I like to, entertain. I like to do that kind of thing. And it's harder to do on tour. You can do it, but I always like to start off tour. I'm like, I'm going to cook. I'm going to set up a station somehow. It doesn't work. You're eating Cliff Bars by day 2.
Yeah. I'll miss definitely just my bed and the couch. Those are usually the two places I stay on. And I like to cook, too. And we have friends over sometimes. Just sometimes I don't, because sometimes I don't like them at times. But just kidding. Couldn't bother watching.
I'm going to just miss my kid and my wife. And I love San Francisco where I am, so I sort of miss the city, especially in the summer, because in the summer it's super cold. And so surprisingly, it's like the coldest part of the year for us, sort of. Whoa. Yeah, because since it's surrounded by water, when it's hot everywhere else, the heat hits the water and then fog rolls in and then covers the sun. It's a lot like the coldest, it's like Mars. The coldest winter I ever spent was a summer in San Francisco. That's a very famous thing. What are you guys going to miss about home?
I'm going to miss my wife and my dog.
Yep. Did you recently just get married?
I got married
a month ago? 2 months ago?
6 weeks, maybe?
What did you dance to at your wedding?
We danced to... What did we dance to?
Oh, boy.
My wife's watching right now. She's probably mad at me. Yeah, we did... the first dance was...
First dances?
What?
You remember the first dance?
Don't give him pressure there.
Don't put me on the spot right now, okay? It was Coldplay. Yellow.
Oh my god. Oh my god. All right.
I forgot the name of the freaking song, okay?
Yeah, what are you going to miss about home? Help. What are you going to miss about home? Help him. It just got worse. It was like, oh, I can't remember. Like, I was thinking, oh, it's a... And then you were, like, going through the albums, and then you were going through the tracks, and then you finally... Holy shit. Oh, boy.
I'm going to miss... So I'm moving to a new part of the city, and I'm going to miss exploring this new part. I wish I could tell you what part it's going to be, but...
Why can't you?
Yeah, why being so weird?
It's either the West Village, Chelsea, Tribeca, or Union Square. One of those four.
You definitely are not going to miss Definitely not going to miss exploring Union Square, because that is just not the place to explore. That's incredible. You're like, I'm either going to miss going to Paris, London, or the McDonald's down the street on the corner. Like, one of them definitely isn't going to happen.
Just so you guys know, I have five more minutes, and then I got to go.
Where are you going?
There's a woman coming to look at the apartment.
This apartment that you're in?
That I'm in right now. This is the apartment I'm moving out of.
You gotta get her on the Google Hangout.
Yeah, you gotta get her on the Google Hangout.
Please tell me she's early.
What? Here, another question. What is your one must-have from home that you bring with you on tour?
I would say there's something called a Lumio. It's like
You making this up?
No, it's a book lamp, and you open the book, and the pages light up, right? So, you charge.
Oh, I wish I had it.
You charge the book, and then it lasts for like 3 hours. So, like when you're in like a green room that's like too bright, or like a hotel room that has bad lighting, you just turn the lights off and open the book, and it's magical.
That's incredible. Philip, what do you bring?
I just bring clothes.
Imagine, you're like, sometimes I bring clothes.
We're the same outfit, the whole tour.
You just hang out. Eric, what do you bring?
I'm big into, like, travel gear and packing stuff, and me and my band geek out on, like, new suitcases and new things. So I've got, like, all these kind of, like, traveling compartments with zippers, and I just got this new thing I'm very excited about. It's like a hanging closet, and then it flattens down with all the clothes, and then when you get to the next place, you pull it open, and it like hangs in the big closet again.
Dude.
It's pretty great.
Wait, but then it wrinkles the clothes and then doesn't...
So you roll them up. You know, you got to put them in an order. So it's like, I'll show it to you.
Oh, okay. Wait.
You guys won't ever be in the same place at the same time.
Yeah, huh? That's true.
You guys aren't going to ever be on the same show at the same time, so you won't be able to show. Very Sisyphus of you to have something that makes your clothes, like, unwrinkled and then wrinkles them, and then you have to unwrinkle them and wrinkle them.
It's a very big word, Sisyphus.
That is a big word.
Sisyphus. I got to bring my tea. I'm super into tea, loose leaf tea, because I don't drink coffee, and so I bring a teapot and tea.
What kind of tea?
I have a bunch of different kinds from this. There's a Chinese tea shop in here out in the Sunset that I go to, and the guy just kind of go in, and he does his whole shtick, and he'll be like this, and I left with like a matcha. I left with this incredible green tea that was like prohibitively expensive. You know what I mean? Like tea nerds are – I try not to get too obsessive compulsive about it, but I just sort of bring it, and I try and enjoy it, and it's all good.
Nice. Next question. What gives you the most energy up on stage?
Cocaine.
Besides cocaine.
The love of a good group of people.
Wait, is that
like an orgy? Oh my god, this is fun.
Okay, you guys, seriously, I have 1 minute.
Well, who is this person? Has she rung the bell?
Not here yet.
I know, but I don't want it to be like...
I'll stay on while you'll
show the apartment. She's going to, like, ring the doorbell and be like, bye!
I'll stay on, you'll show the apartment.
No.
Yeah, we can tell her. We want to have this experience with you, man.
I second that. I second Phillips.
Okay.
Here's the deal. I have a question. Is it your apartment and you're renting it out, or you're... Explain to me the scenario.
So I'm renting an apartment right now, and I'm moving out for July 1st. However, the building said that they can get a woman to possibly rent it out starting tomorrow.
Jesus, you're really moving. That's no joke.
Starting tomorrow?
I'm moving tomorrow.
And I moved 2 days ago.
Where did you move to?
I moved 5 blocks away from where I currently live. But it's like...
Docked a lot? You guys are real secretive. I like it.
We're moving farther away from each other.
Oh, that's sad.
Probably healthy. I just think it's healthy just for the creative process.
Yeah.
I also want you guys to know that I am literally right next door to you right now. It's like the other line, it's me. I'm in the house. This is a horror movie, and I'm in the house with you. Did you guys ever see that movie where they were all on Skype and they all got killed?
No, I know. Unfriended.
Yeah, dude, that's it. That's how. If you end up leaving, you have to leave like you've been killed by a spirit.
Okay. And then but there might be something wrong with the. Oh!
That was an incredible way for him to get off the thing. Oh, you're back.
He lives.
I think we only have another 9 minutes left of this tomfoolery anyway.
All right.
Cool. Well, just in case you don't know why you're watching this, all of us are going on tour together.
Who loves this?
This summer.
This, we should all say one word, like this
summer.
Ooh.
We're going up for the summer. We'd love to see you guys. So hopefully you'll make it out. And I'm hoping the show is going to be more organized than this was today.
Yeah, we're going to play you some music.
Dude, incredible. We're going to play Peter Gabriel, a Jeff Lynne, obscure Jeff Lynne cover, and then and a Prince song. I'm in.
Also, this is what Lumio looks like, in case you don't know.
Oh, wait, so show me... Oh, so the book itself... Oh, wait a second.
And it closes, and it looks like just a normal book, and then it opens and it looks like that.
I'm confused. Is that the actual book? Like, if I had War and Peace, it would light up like that?
No.
It's a lamp.
There's no words on the pages.
Oh, but it goes behind your... But you read no words?
It's like extra lighting.
You don't read it.
Can you show me that again?
When he looks at the blank pages and tells his own story.
Yeah.
It's a book-shaped lamp, right? Book-shaped lamp, pretty much.
Your planet. It is so strange. That, and where do you put that on your purse? Like on your person, if you're lying down?
No, you put it on the desk. You put it on the table, the floor, the couch.
All at once?
No.
Upright can it get?
You pick one.
Oh.
And you put it. You put it.
I like to put it in my bunk.
Hey-o. I like to put it in my trunk. It's like a Dr. Seuss play. Like, I won't not put it in my trunk bunk.
Guys, do you guys get nervous about sleeping in the bottom or middle bunk? That the bunk on top of you is gonna fall on you?
I've had that fear for sure.
Well, wait, a bunk actually fell on Ian's bunk.
No, dude, I was scared to sleep in the middle bunk for some reason on this tour, and then on the last day of tour, 30 minutes after I got out of the bunk, the top bunk fell onto my bunk. with someone in it.
No, that sucks.
Dude, that's crazy.
You were unharmed.
I was unharmed, but I'm never sleeping in. I'm only sleeping on the top from now on.
He's only going to be the one that crushes everyone.
Yeah, yeah.
I think I live with survivor's guilt.
That's incredible. I don't understand. There's a lot of wood that goes into keeping those things up.
It was the front. So it didn't go down all at once. It was like the front half of it came down. I still would have gotten injured.
That sucks. You would have crushed your feet or something.
It would have crushed my feet better than my head.
I was thinking about Airbnb being one of our empty bunks this summer.
That sounds like a fun thing.
Just to make it a little
bit. Make it a fan experience.
Yeah, fan experience.
That's not a bad idea.
Dude, people have to get somewhere. That, like, you put on Craigslist, you're like, heading to Tempe, anyone? You know, you want to sleep on a semi-obscure person's bus? Like, have fun. Let's do this.
I like that idea. It's kind of like Airbnb mixed with Uber. It's like, you want to sleep, you want to get to this place. We've got two bunks available.
Dude.
Here we go. That's fire. We're on to something, guys.
I'm excited about this. I feel like we could all go in on this business and make it happen.
Let's do it.
I've already got funding going on it.
We just told... How many people are watching this thing? Do you know?
They can't even log in to ask us questions. You think they're going to start a business?
Or it's just all my fault.
Are you kidding me? This is the best hour I've spent in a long time. This is, like, incredible. I feel like this is like a summer camp. We got to all do this again. All right.
At the end of the tour, as a wrap-up, when everyone, no one wants to speak to each other anymore, or we're all best friends, it'll be great.
Yeah.
I was going to say something else really funny and rude, but I didn't do it. I'm good.
Nice.
The rubbed one out really got silence. For everybody on this group that masturbates, I was surprised at how many people did not have my back.
Too honest, maybe? I don't know.
It's all we're here for, Eric. Too
honest.
Hey, okay, hold on. When you rap, say something about all the dates are below the video, and we would love to see everyone.
We would love to see everyone, and make sure that you check out all the tour dates at the bottom of this chat, and we'll see.
Oh, dude. I just found out where some more questions were coming from.
Oh, fuck. Where? Oh, come on. Are any of them about ice cream?
I haven't seen it yet. Dang it. I wish I would have seen this earlier.
Dude.
If the tour is as much fun as I'm having right now, it's going to be a great tour.
It won't be.
It's not going to
be. No. Dude, I honestly can't wait. I mean, like, this was super rad. I've been on tours before where, and I'm sure you all have, where the other people are kind of like dead inside, atomic, like just like dead inside. So like, this is going to be really nice. I'm not going to name names, but you know what I'm saying? Just like in the history of my long career of making tours happen. So like, anybody out there watching this, if you want to experience something even remotely close to the joy that you feel when you drink, watch television, or get carnal with people that you care about or just met, you're going to want to come out and see the Philip Phillips, Matt Nathanson, A Great Big World, Eric Hutchinson Summer Extravaganza. The tour dates are below. Just look down on your little computer. Just shut that porn screen and just look right in there, and there it is.
Matt, you should be like an anchor on the Today Show.
Imagine. I would put myself on there every week so I could tell. I'd be like, and musical guest Matt Nathanson.
Outstand.
Like this.
All right, I think we can kind of end it, guys.
If we want. Thank you guys for hanging out with us.
Hey, check out the tour, everyone that's watching.
That was incredible.
It'll be awesome.
You guys, that was super fucking fun. Thanks for hanging.